Hey guys, it's Ben with CACCIA Outdoors. I just wanted to bring you a short video about prepping a cooler and using a cooler for carrying game meat and keeping your game meat safe. So there's a few things to know when you get a cooler. A lot of people just get a cooler, they throw a bunch of ice in it and put their meat in it and they call it good. And then they wonder why their meat tastes gamey later. There's a few rules you gotta pay attention to. Let's start at the beginning. When you go to purchase a cooler, if this is something that you're going to use to transport your precious game meat from the field to home, whether it's from, you know, Colorado to somewhere on the East Coast or backcountry California to somewhere else in California, either way, from when you harvest the animal to when you get it home is usually more than a day. Most spots, you know, when you're doing backcountry hunting, it's several days. So obviously, how you take care of the meat in the field, where you hang it, all that stuff, super critical, but that's another video. For cooler selection, it's really important to go with a roto-molded cooler. There's a lot of top brands, you know, I'm not even gonna start naming them, but you know all the brands. Yeti is the one that I have. I really like Yetis, but to be honest with you, there's probably a marginal difference between Yeti and like an Ozark Trail roto-molded cooler. You don't have to spend, you know, $600 for a 100-quart cooler. You could probably get away with getting one, a decent one, for a couple $100. That's gonna achieve generally the same thing. The important part is once you have a roto-molded cooler, they just keep stuff much cooler than like your traditional flimsy, you know, going camping cooler. You have your roto-molded cooler, now you're getting ready to go hunting. The important thing is to prep your cooler at least a day in advance. So the night before, you want to leave the cooler, just crack the lid and just kind of leave it open, prop it open with something and let it get cold, at least to ambient temperature outside or whatever. Let it get down to the ambient temperature the night before. That way you have to work less on cooling your cooler down and more on maintaining it being cold. So you've propped it open, you left it open all night, it's down to whatever the nighttime temperature is. Maybe it's only 60 degrees, maybe it's 40 something. The lower the better, obviously. But now your cooler is down to the ambient temperature of the nighttime air. Early morning, you get up, now what do? So I like to use freezer blocks in my coolers. The cool thing is, freezer blocks, these freeze from 5 degrees to negative 15. That's the temperature these blocks will hold. The huge advantage over ice with freezer blocks is, A, they don't melt and then make a giant wet mess in your meat, because you obviously don't want wet game meat in your cooler. Water and game meat are enemies. Never get it wet. So these eliminate all the water. If you just line your cooler with these things, they'll also keep it colder. These freeze down to 5 degrees Fahrenheit, negative 15 Celsius. And that's important because the colder you can get your ice blocks, the longer they're gonna stay cold because they're gonna keep this cooler colder inside. So super critical component here. Yeti makes them. There's a lot of different brands. I like this Arctic Ice brand. The purple one is the Tundra series, and it's the coldest freezing ice block. So keep that in mind. I usually will stack four of them along the bottom of the cooler or however many will fit. And then what I'll do from there is I'll freeze a bunch of 1 gallon jugs of water, 2 liters of water. I'll fill up water bottles or water containers and stick them in there on top of the Tundra ice or below it, whatever, doesn't really matter. And that just creates more volume in the cooler overall before you get your meat in there. And then on top of that, I'll pile in a bunch of ice bags, you know, a 50 pound ice bag or a couple 20s or whatever fits in your cooler, pile it in there. Keep it in the bag so it's not just slushy everywhere like we talked about. We don't want a bunch of water in there. And then your cooler is pretty much full. So keeping your cooler full is another critical component of keeping it cold. The more air space that's in your cooler, the more fluctuation in temperature you're gonna get from ambient temperature change. So if this cooler's sitting outside or sitting in a truck and it's 95 degrees or 100 degrees like it is when we hunt in California early season, and there's a bunch of space in the cooler of empty air, it's gonna start getting warm really quick on you, even if you've got freezer blocks and a Yeti and all that. So it's really important to keep your cooler full as much as possible, even if you just put ice in there for temporary, bags of ice. And then what we do is we'll just chuck the bags of ice out, dump the ice out when we kill something and want to put it in the cooler because we don't need that anymore. We'll stuff it in another cooler with drinks. So another tip for you is when you put your game meat in the cooler. Now, the idealistic situation is you take your game meat and you hang it overnight So it cools down from the regular body temperature of the deer, the elk, or whatever at 105 or 103 or whatever the body temperature of those animals are. Then it cools down. You want to get the hide off and the guts out. All that's basic stuff. You hang the thing in a cool place. And it, you know, if it's freezing temperatures outside, then none of this really matters as much. But you hang the thing and cool it down. If you can get the temperature of the meat all the way to the middle, down to like the 50s or 40s, that's awesome. Most of the time you don't have the luxury of getting your meat hung outside and cooled down to 40 degrees. Most of the places where we hunt in California, it cools down to 60 degrees at best. So as long as your meat can cool down to the high 60s, low 60s, whatever it is, cool it as much as you can before you put it in the cooler. If you put hot meat in the cooler, it's gonna heat up all your ice blocks, melt your ice blocks, and it's gonna heat up the inside of the cooler to the temperature of the meat. So that's something else to pay attention to. All right, guys, I hope these tips have helped you. Implement them this year when you're hunting, especially if it's warm weather, early season hunting. Implement these tips, and hopefully your game will taste less gamey when you get it home. Thanks for watching, guys. Like and subscribe, and we'll catch you on the next video.